someone asked me once if I was a cultural ambassador for Yiddish, and I said, I don't know if there's like a diplomatic, like, if there was an embassy somewhere for Yiddish land, I don't know. I wouldn't work there. I mean, there's other people here who might, but I like being a smuggler more than an ambassador, you know? I like smuggling Yiddish into other contexts where you wouldn't expect to encounter it. Musicians have always been on the edges of cultures, on borders of cultures, because it's just the sort of the social role of the musician. I think it's a pretty great deal. And so, for me, those are the places where culture flourishes, when it comes in contact with other cultures, those on the borders. That's where creolization happens, that's where adaptation happens, that's where exchange happens. And I'm interested in exchange, I'm interested in openness, in challenging borders, moving them, destroying them, you know, or at least questioning them or examining them. And Yiddish, that's one of the things that turns me on about Yiddish. I mean, like, structurally, as a language, like, it was always about that. Regardless of how many of Yiddish speakers lived in an isolated world, I mean, I think that the development of the language, because it was a multinational language, it was a transnational language, it was so open, you know, and it drank in so much of the world around it, and it affected the world around it, and it was cosmopolitan and traveling and dangerous. It was dangerous for anybody who wants to hang their hat on a national identity and as if it's something real. Because I think it shows us that those walls don't actually exist.